You get to see Thomas Lutie. This is the third session now in a row where Lutie is looking like a different rider to the one we saw in the first half of the year. This is what we've been expecting.
Hoping
Tom. I'm hoping for Tom.
Could well be. Thank you for that insight there, Simon. As we just saw as well, I did wonder, it was Jorge Navarro trackside. He's gone down at turn one. I did wonder, oh, is that another one at turn three? Could be perfect timing, but thank you.
Just unprecedented levels. And yeah, you do wonder whether that's maybe having a bit of an effect leading to that that problem up at turn three.
And Xavi Vieja-esque tour of the top teams then, potentially, as I mentioned yesterday.
Yeah, it would strike you as slightly strange for Agosto to be doing that, because it's just one lap after the other, low 1 minute 29s, very, very consistent. 37 there, thumbs up from the team. They absolutely like what they're seeing. Pierre Carrillo just there, former technician. Similarly strange crash on the exit of turn three yesterday. We didn't quite actually see what happened to him, just the aftermath, him running to his machine. Wasn't midway down the straight between turn three and four, but it was quite a bit away.
Just, some people are saying, oh, it's a bit hard, is it, out there? You're not going very well, or when are you coming back home? It was like, world championship? Excuse me?
Yeah. Have you watched Model 2 before?
Yeah. Time that he's been to a Moto America race since he got his first podium, actually, in all those pole positions. So nice for them two to get a bit of recognition from the home crowd of what they're doing, which is nice. Cameron and that, just more patience. This is really hard.
Sitting really pretty at the moment. Fifth place. Dream session so far for the Honda Team Asia boys, with Ayagura sitting third.
Lutie well in touch at the third split, as towards his best as well, as we're looking at Marcus Ramirez come across the line. 17th up to 6th for him and 4th for Lutie. How about it? Whereas really good stuff from Lutie, as we mentioned. Marcus Ramirez this week,
a bit of adversity. And Fernandez is certainly not going that in a straightforward manner this weekend for him.
Absolutely. This is Jake Dixon on your screens, P21 for the Brit at the moment. Downbeat after yesterday. Of course, position is one thing, but your time off top is another.
He said yesterday it was a combination of things that led to a pretty bad place overall on the leaderboards. But he also acknowledged that this has just been a track that he's never quite got on with. He had 1 sixth place here so far back that very, very little chance of him fighting for the championship this year in Moto 2. 111 points back. I mean, he's not going to.
Let's see. Dejan Antonio, of course, already signed up for next year with MotoGP. With him seeing Marcel Schrotter up to 6th place now for the German. So this is looking much better from him.
Yeah, Schrotter, I was surprised to see over the summer break that he's actually jumped up to 6th in the championship in
racing. I don't think I'll be used again.
Yeah, we'll retire that one immediately, I think.
Well, look like that. But yes, Ayagura, another more solid pace from him. Does he lose much in the third section? Dalla Porta, 10th for him. Arvelino, 8th, and personal best for the Italian. So following in the trail of his German teammate Marcel Schrotter, a bit of a
hey boys, Schrotter and Arbolino, 7th and 8th. As it stands, we're seeing quite a few improvements coming in. Fabio Di Gianantonio jumps up to 15th. His countryman Celestino Vietti, one place ahead. And look at this from Bezzecchi, might have missed most of this. It's that Cam saves his best for Sunday. He's a real Sunday man. Working, of course, with the highly experienced Stuart Shenzhen.
One at the second sector, one at the final sector. So, hopefully this time around, same with Dejan Antonio. But what about Vietti, Neil? Third split, nearly 3.5 tenths off. Oh, just misses out a bit more. Agüero has a great first.
Including Xavi Vieira, Joe Roberts, Cameron Bobier, Jorge Navarro.
Yeah, take Dixon as well amongst that group. Pete Stuffen, both of those guys. Bezeki across the line once again. No improvement, but he'll be solid in P2. Could be.
Yeah, did you shuffle back from 14th to 16th? And he's having to Nabil out of that, but he can't afford to mess around too long because he's just looking for a little space on the track, I think, indeed, just like he did yesterday morning.
Yeah, absolutely. Bezeki clearly working very well on remaining calm in situations where the odds are against him.
Sectors 3 and 4. But Remy Gardner on another quick one, as is Augusto Fernandez.
And Aaron Canet
as
Aaron
well. Canet, yeah.
So Gardner crosses the line, no improvement for him. He's got Reynos ahead of him and Reynos outside the top 14. P3 for him as well. Any major shufflers? No. Just a lot of people crossing the line and that's it really. Oh, we've got a crash for Vietti. Ah, that's a shame. Turn 4 for him.
Well, last time we saw him before the summer break, Remy Gardner once again is the man, and well, usually over a single flying lap, so fast.
Yeah. Yep, so true. See how that transpires in towards the race.
Perfect conditions up in the Austrian mountains, right in the heart of Austria here in Styria, and it is from Remy Gardner on top. And it looks like to me Gardner's found something today that wasn't there yesterday.
Yeah, I think it's definitely been a little looking fast here today.
Looking further down, there's Jake Dixon in 26th position. Not what he wants to see at all.